Hello all, welcome to the Target Main Standings program by Neo IAS. We'll now see one of the key issue which is in discussion. It is regarding India's drone use policy version 1.0. Recently, the Ministry of Civil Aviation has come up with a policy which is regulating the usage of drones in our nation. And that is something which is known as the India's drone use policy. We will now quickly see what are all the features in this policy, and we will now try to do a quick analysis of both positive as well as the negative aspects of this policy. Now, before that, we need to understand what is basically a drone. You would have seen that, especially in probably in shooting mechanisms, in wedding ceremony, etc. It is basically an unmanned aerial vehicle. Unmanned aerial vehicle means a vehicle wherein which a human is not sitting inside and regulating its operation. So, it's an unmanned aerial vehicle which is commonly known as drone. Now, a drone is basically a part of an unmanned aircraft system. So, understand that drone is part of an unmanned aircraft system wherein which it will have a UAV, that is this entity, unmanned aerial vehicle, and a ground-based controller. One controller mechanism would be there in the ground, and this will control the movement of this drone, and there is a proper communication system which has been happening between the controller as well as the unmanned aerial vehicle. That is the idea of drone. Now, if that is drone, let us now quickly go and see what are all the policy features. This policy has been released by the Director General of Civil Aviation, that is the Ministry related to Civil Aviation, and this policy is the first draft, and that is currently it is known as the National Drone Policy version 1.0. Now, this policy is set to be effect from the end of this year, that is from 1st December 2018 is when this policy is going to be in place. Every drone, now what are all some of the features in this policy? This policy is saying that every drone which is now has to be flied in our nation, that needs to be registered. There should be a registry of the owner of the drone, then about the drone that is being used as well as the person who is going to fly the drone. Registry part of three entities is what is going to happen. Register about first one, who is owning that drone. Second one, about that drone itself, you know, what type it is, what are all the specifications pertaining to that drone, that needs to be registered, as well as the person who is going to fly that drone, that needs to be registered. Then, to be eligible for the remotely piloted aircraft system, a drone is something wherein which, you know, somebody is controlling that system from the ground. So that is why it is actually known as a remotely piloted aircraft system. For somebody to fly the drone, as per the new policy, that person must be over 18 years of age. Then second thing is, must have passed 10th examination in English, because the specification or the rules and regulations is something which that person needs to know, and has that person should have undergone practical training as approved by the Director General of Civil Aviation. Should it be over 18 years of age? Second one is, you know, he should have passed standard 10 in English medium, and he should have got prior experience or he should have undergone the training which has been approved by the DGC. Now, the drones per this policy is basically of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 types. Those are something which is one of the nano drones, micro drones, small drone, medium drones, as well as the large drones. Nano drones are drones which is less than or equal to 250 gram. If their weight is less than 250 gram, they are known as nano drones. Micro is from the range of 250 gram to 2 kilogram, whereas small is from 2 kilogram to 25 kilogram. I'll repeat it once more. Nano less than 250, micro from 250 to 225, micro is from 250 to 2, small is from 2 to 25, whereas medium is from 25 to 150 kilogram, and large sets of drones are those drones which are greater than 150 kilogram. These are the types of drones which has been envisaged. Now, every category of the drone, that is the drones, you know, which we have seen before, that is micro, nano, small, medium, large, etc., they will need to get something which is known as UAOP, that is Unmanned Aircraft Operator Permit. An operator permit is something which the people should get before flying the drones, where there are some exceptions to this criteria. That is, if you are flying a nano category drone below 50 feet, the height is 50 feet, if you are going to fly a nano category drone below 50 feet, you don't have to get an approval or you don't have to get an unmanned aircraft operator permit. Whereas, if you are going to fly a micro drone below the height of 200, so nano below 50 feet, micro below 200 feet in an uncontrolled airspace, that is, those are regions where in which proper air passage or flight traffic is not something which is on a very prominent note. In those cases, nano, micro, or if this drone is something which has been owned by either NTRO or by the Central Intelligence Agencies. It is, what is NTRO? Nanotechnical Research Organization. If the drones are owned by the government mechanisms like this, and in these two categories, they don't have to get the UAOP permit before. Then, except the nano, the other two have to intimate the police according to the provisions. That is, before flying a drone, even if you know they don't have to get the UAOP thing, the drones, for that drones to be flying, they need to get prior approval from the police. That is the micro as well as the other drones. Then, this UAOP which is being implemented or which will be given, that is, that will be, if somebody is applying for this unmanned aircraft operator permit, that will be, or that needs to be granted to them within a period of 7 days, and this UAOP will be valid for a period of 5 years. 7 days is when somebody should be getting that after they apply, and that will be valid for a period of 5 years. The DGCA is also ensuring that there should be a UIN or a unique identification number for a drone as well as another feature of this policy, so that there should be a proper tracking of where all the drones has been flying in our nation. So this UIN, 2 days of the receipt of the application with complete documents. When somebody has asked for an approval to fly a drone, UIN need to be produced or UIN need to be given to them within a period of 2 days. Then this flying area, if you have to fly a drone, that is now divided into some of the areas like red zones, yellow zones and green zones. Red zones, yellow zones and green zones. So red zones means it is no flying area. You cannot fly a drone in those regions. That would include the region which is close to airports, the military bases, borders, region which is close to borders, etc. You cannot fly a drone. Then yellow zones means flying in that area is possible, provided you get a proper approval mechanism. Whereas green area or green zones are the unrestricted areas. Then, users are not allowed to operate a drone from a mobile platform. Suppose you are traveling in a vehicle, you are traveling in a car, you are traveling in a train. In such a scenario, you are not supposed to operate a drone because that can cause a lot of havoc. Then, another thing is eco-sensitive zones, you know, like the national parks, wildlife sanctuaries, etc. If you want to fly a drone in those regions, that should be, or you should be able to do that only with prior approvals, with prior permissions. Another key word for us to remember in the national drone policy is something which is known as NPNT. NPNT, that is no permission, no takeoff, which means that as long as the drone has not satisfied the regulatory checks and mechanisms, if it has not overcome that, the drone should not be able to fly. Such kind of a hardware inbuilt mechanism is something which needs to be built in, is the idea of no permission, no takeoff. I'll repeat it once more. As long as the drone hardware or the drone hardware has to be configured in such a manner that unless the regulatory permissions which has been given for a drone to be fly is not achieved, you cannot fly the drone. That is the idea of NPNT. Now, again, a person, suppose you are now operating a drone, per this policy, you cannot operate multiple drones at a time, because again, that will cause lot of havoc and lot of issues for people. No drone is allowed to carry any hazardous materials and animal or human inside that. No hazardous materials, no animals, and no human payloads. Then, this UIN, that is the identification number, or the UAOP, which has been issued by the DGA, if they are seeing that these regulations has been violated, the DGCA has got the right to suspend both. So, which means drone flying is now going to happen in India in a very legal and authentic manner. Then, according to the new draft policy, you cannot fly a drone within 5 kilometers from the airports of metro regions, whereas within the 3 kilometers in other regions, you cannot fly a drone. I'll repeat it once more. As per the new policy, you cannot fly the drones near to airports. Why? Because you know that will now have an impact in the air traffic health system. If the airport is in metro regions like Mumbai, Delhi, Chennai, Kolkata, etc., within the radius of 5 km, you cannot fly this drone. Whereas for the other regions, this has been limited to, or for the other airport, this has been limited to the radius of 3 kilometers. Then, all operators except for nano drone operators, that is all people who are operating a drone except the nano drone operators, they are required to file their flight plan. That is, this time, this day, I am going to fly this drone. That kind of a flight plan they need to submit, and they need to get proper clearances from Indian Air Force and Air Traffic Control and the Flight Information Center. So that any, because you know, as you would know, the flight mechanisms or the flight routes are already pre-planned. So, in that scenario, you know, suppose and without any intimation, a drone is now harbingering into the path where which a flight has been flowing, that can cause accidents. So, to avoid that, to fly a drone except nano drone, that is, you know, even to fly a micro drone, you need to get this proper approval before. That is it. Okay. Let us now quickly revise the features of this policy. First one is, this has been released by the Director General of Civil Aviation. So, it is related to the Ministry of Civil Aviation. Now, this is going to be with effect from December 2018. Now, what is the first thing, you know, with the policy saying is that the drone owner, the person who is going to fly the drone as well as the drone that is being used needs to be properly registered. So, the registration mechanism is one thing which has been ensured in this one. For a person who is going to fly this drone, he should be above 18 years of age. He should have passed at least standard 10th exam in English medium, as well as he should be or he should have undergone the training which has been approved or which has been offered by the DGCA. Then, drone is of different type, which is known as the nano, micro, small, medium and larger drones. Again, for somebody to or get a UAOP is essential. What is UAOP? Unmanned aircraft operator permit is essential. Now, there are some exceptions which has been proposed for UAOP. That is, if you are flying a nano category drone below 50 feet and that is not in a proper airspace or in an uncontrolled airspace, that is fine. Then, if at all you are going to fly a micro drone below 200 feet and that is in an uncontrolled airspace, that is fine. You don't have to get prior approval. Whereas, the third scenario was if a drone was owned by the ministries or owned by the government agencies like NTRO, Central Indian Agencies, etc., those scenarios are something where in which you need to get a prior approval. Now, UAOP will be valid for a period of 5 years. When somebody applies for an unmanned aircraft operator permit, that should be granted to them within a period of 7 days. Other one was regarding the UIN. What was UIN? Unique identification number has to be there for a drone. And when somebody applies for a UIN, that should be granted to them within a period of 2 days since they have applied for this UIN. Then, flying areas was something, you know, which we need to take care of. That is, it would include areas like red zones, yellow zones and green zones. Red zones, you cannot fly those drones. In yellow zones, you can fly those drones with prior approval. Whereas in green zones, you don't have an issue in flying the drone. If you are in a mobile platform, you are not allowed to operate a drone, then there is something which is known as NPNT. NPNT, that is no permission, no takeoff. As long as the regulatory clearances are not obtained by a drone, the hardware of a drone should be configured in a such a manner that it cannot be able to do the takeoff process. So proper regulation is what is required for the takeoff process to happen. Somebody cannot carry the drone with any hazardous material, with an animal or a human payload. Last is, more than one operation of more than one drone cannot be done by a person at the same time. Then, we have also seen that the UIA and UAOP which has been issued can be cancelled by the DGCA if they feel that there is a proper violation of the rules which has been stipulated. They could have the right to cancel that. Then, you cannot fly a drone within 5 kilometers or within a radius of 5 kilometers in metro airports. Whereas, for other airports, the drone cannot be flown within the 3 kilometer radius. Now, all operators except for nano drone operators, they have to obtain clearances from the Indian Air Force, Air Traffic Control and the Flight Information Center at least 24 hours before the operation of the drone. Now, we have seen the drones policy, we have revised that. Now, from this policy, what are the positive segments or what are the positives pertaining to this policy, something in which we will look up into. Before this policy, we were not having a standard or structured mechanism through which the flying of drone can be regulated. So the first idea is, through this policy, the government is now at least attempting in coming up with a proper structure and rule mechanism for the flying of drone in our nation. So the development of a drone infrastructure with a proper structure is one of the first positive which we can say from this policy. Then, policy is a welcome step. Why? Because it is reiterating the position that India is open to embrace new technologies. If you take our counterparts like US, China, etc., they are already investing massive amounts in advanced technologies. So, India can now use the drone technology for benefits in these sectors. In which all sectors? In sectors like e-commerce, agriculture, engineering, industrial sector, monitoring, photography, emergency services, etc. So, since we are now having a proper policy in place, is the reason why we are giving our citizens a legal authentication in terms of using the drones. Because of the usage of drones, there can be technical advancements happening in all these segments. Another key area where in which this is going to have a massive impact is in the aerial photography sector. Because for commercial shooting as well as for gathering information regarding a region, even for a GIS mapping, etc., you could now use drones. So that would help in getting data with proper traction. The last point is that one of the challenge was, if the drone has been used by somebody against anti-national activities, how could we properly track it? Or that can have an issue in terms of the security of our nation was one of the key issues. Now, the CISF is now planning to procure something which is known as procure technology which is known as integrated counter drone management system. Integrated counter drone management system. So, what would that technology help us? With that technology, you know, they would now clearly be able to see what type of drone it is. Where all are this drone flying up into? And third thing is, if the drone is not following the proper legal or the regulatory matters, they could have a mechanism wherein which they could even disable the functioning of the drone. So, which means that if that technology is been adopted by our nation, there is a high possibility that this drone technology can be used for the betterment of our nation in the development of these many sectors. So, we have seen the drone policy, we have seen its positives. Let us now quickly see what are all the negatives involved with the national drone policy. First one is that, if a UAN need to be issued for a drone, as we have seen before, that is one of the key stipulation in the policy. There is a lot of documentation involved. So, that is one of the most time consuming process, and again, that is not going to help the structural flow in the process. So, that time, long list of documentation, and to even, you know, there have been instances where you need to get clearances from the Ministry of Home Affairs in several cases. So, the process is something which is taking some time. It is not ideal. So, that is one of the first negative of this policy. Second one is, you know, even you have to fly a micro drone. We have seen nano, micro, medium, large, small drones, etc. Even if you have to fly a micro drone below 200 feet, you need to get the approval from the local police station 24 hours before the flight. Again, a lot of policy or the process havoc is involved again there as well. Third one is that, suppose you know, we are now giving a legal mechanism for the implementation of drones in our nation. So the people who are going to manufacture this drone, they need to do a lot of test flying before the actual implementation of the drone product per se. Even to do the test flying, you know, they have to get all this approvals, etc. prior, which is again delaying the process a lot. So there can also be an element of red tapeism involved, saying that, you know, probably, you know, one company, if they are going to give, say, probably, you know, some amount of bribe to the officers, that can be the stage only when, you know, they will be giving approval. So that kind of red tapeism possibility is again one of the challenge involved in this one. The best thing was, you know, if you are able to avoid any interferences between this government officials and for the manufacturing companies on a very frequent basis, the process would take on in a normal manner. Then the other thing is that currently they have identified some testing areas as well as for some areas to do the demonstration of the drones. The sad part of this one is that, let us take the case of a place which is known as Chitradurga and Coorg and Gani Mangala village. Chitradurga, Coorg and Gani Mangala village. These are the places which has been identified, say, probably to do the test running of a drone. These cities are actually very far from the city of Bangalore, where in which the major operation of the drone would be done. So that is again not a very ideal situation for the policy to work upon. That is it. So we'll revise upon the negative aspect one more. First one is that there is a lot of documentation process involved in getting in the UIN. Second thing is, even to fly a micro drone, you have to get approvals, and that is again creating a lot of process issues with that. Third thing is, there can be a possibility of red tapeism happening, because every time, even for the manufacturers, testers, etc., for them to see how the drone is being functioning, they need to get proper approvals. So that is again, there is a possibility of red tapeism. Last one is, the identified areas which has been identified for doing the test as well as for the demonstration, that is actually very far from the technological hub and the developmental centers. For example, the Chitradurga, Coorg and Gani Mangala village, which has been identified. Even one village, you know, named Gani Mangala, they are not even applying in Google, they are not even visible in Google Maps. And that is again very far from the key technological hub center. That is it. Thank you so much.